morning, welcome everybody. So we have a nice crew here, and we also have some of the members. What I want to do today is just present an overview of Agile Project Management. So I'll do a quick poll in a few minutes to see what your level of experience is. I know there are some people from some team members from Zevia here, and they are certainly not novices anymore. So they've been doing Agile for a while. So we'll call on them to answer some questions and draw on their experience as well. I've been in the IT field, in the industry, for about 20 years. And I've been doing Agile for coming up to half that period. So I've been working with Agile methods for about 9, almost 10 years. I started with a method, one of the Agile methods, which is called extreme programming. Extreme programming projects, started about 9 or 10 years ago. And I came from a conventional project management background. And then the question became, what is the project manager's job on an Agile project? And in those days, we didn't have a lot of guidance. If you read the early XP books, I think it was by Kent Beck, Introduction to Extreme Programming, there's one paragraph on what a project manager is supposed to do. And the line I remember from that paragraph is something about bringing the team pizza and removing obstacles for the team. So I thought, okay, I can do that, but what else do I do besides bringing pizza to the team and removing obstacles? So kind of a fuzzy thing. So a lot of, Anurag mentioned my book, Managing Agile Projects, and a lot of the material that's in there came from my experiences over the next few years, actually managing these projects and trying to figure out what a potentially project manager has to do on an Agile project. So what I present to you today is my view as a project manager, because I still manage projects, I'm still involved, either consulting with other people who are doing project management or managing projects myself. My opinion is the same. You do things sufficient to purpose, right? If your purpose is this system has to be around 10 years later, and you are transitioning from one team to the other, from the team that develop the system to another team that has to maintain the system, then obviously with that transfer, you're going to lose, you're not going to have the tacit knowledge. In Agile, we have these terms, tacit versus explicit knowledge. On an Agile team, there's a large amount of tacit knowledge, because that's shared a lot, and your people, you're collaborating with each other to the point that, you're seeing things on a daily basis, you're sharing this collective code ownership. So everyone knows a lot about everything. But once, let's say the whole team is transferring over to a thing, then the situation that you're talking about might come into play. It's like, I need some documentation. I need more documentation, just the code. Now that whole, the code tells the story. I don't buy that. I think you need some design doc. So that's sort of an extreme programming view, or just in my as a project manager, it's like I would like to see a little more robust understanding. But the question is, for what? I mean, if we need to document something for regulation purposes, for audit purposes, compliance purposes, then we'll do that documentation, sufficient purpose. What we won't do is churn out pro forma documentation just, because we're going to do a requirements specification for what? Oh, because we want to do it. Yeah, right. So we're going to do it because we need it. If we need it, we'll do it. So if the need is, so that's the thing. So, and I think that's where Balaji is coming from, is that they have not seen the need to do an extensive UML modeling and documentation and all that. Frankly, I've never seen a system where you need extensive low-level sequence. But there's the level of architecture documentation, overall system functioning, user manual. These are just part of a surrounding packaging of a system that just makes it complete. So, to my effect,
I was
going to
share basically, Agile is like do what makes sense. So
that's right.
It's not about there's a design document template that you need to fill in.
And are you with Zevia as well?
No.
Who are you with? Sorry.
I'm with the same thing, and
with
one exchanging technology.
Okay. They do Agile?
Yeah, we do Agile. Okay. I mean, ours is not an Agile shop, so I'm actually, both my companies are not like an Agile shop.
Gorilla Agile, yeah.
Yeah, we do Agile because it made sense, and we tried following it, and we do it under the covers. So
yeah.
Our organization is not Agile, but we try to do stuff like that. And try to convince people. So we answer questions like, how does Agile work with CMM?
Yeah,
and
that's right. Yeah.
CMM,
you should put together
a FAQ. We answer those sort of questions, but yeah. Under the word, we are like,
yeah.
Fine.
Yeah.
So what I was saying was, as a team, we get into a room, and then we decide, okay, we're going to do this use case or user story, how do we do it and what do we need to decide to do it? And sometimes the design may just be a whiteboard in which we just document the flow,
right.
Just capture it in a camera and just put it on the wiki.
Right.
That's it. I mean,
right.
No documentation required. And that is our design document. So anybody in the team can then look it up and
right.
then figure out how it needs to be done, and that's just it. And then you're very clear how, where, what piece you are writing and how does it come to the workflow.
So
that's how you
go about it. So this documentation thing is it's a rat hole. Every time, this is the number one kind of objection to Azure. The other one close is architecture. Azure does not documentation. So I think we've come up, we've have a couple of balanced discussions. Let's, if necessary, we'll come back and go down the rat hole again. Let's see if there's another question that doesn't relate to it. So this is an interesting question. Can the Agile estimation process be standardized across an organization? Is that that's your question? So what do you mean by that? Let me answer that question at two levels. One is you're saying, can the estimation process be standardized? Absolutely. You can go and you can teach HCL, how many people, like 50,000 people? How many people do we have with them? So 50,000 people, you can teach them all Agile estimation. No problem. Don't expect the estimates to be the same. So I think what you're, there's an implicit second question that you're saying, can the estimates be standardized across the thing? And that is very wrong. Agile explicitly says that estimates are particular to a particular team. So, team A sitting in this room over here, their estimates are theirs only, because they're doing the estimates for that particular team with their particular project context. It's going to be very different from team B in Xavier sitting in the next room to another team in HCL. And of course, you guys are going to be all over multiple locations and all that. So the process itself is simple, right? I mean, you compared to some of the complex, COCOMO 2, COCOMO 3, this, that, and all that, all that stuff that we used to do, the Agile estimation process is fairly simple. I mean, it's a little tough to get to, and people have a big sort of mental block to it first when they first get started. But once they do it for a while, you can standardize the process. You can say, read Mike Cohn's book and create some boot camp and send everybody through that, and you can standardize the process, no problem. Don't standardize the estimates. And don't attempt to compare one estimate. That's a different question. What metrics make sense to try and measure the value that Agile is delivering? So let's hold very bad news for you. And that is productivity. Trying to measure productivity is almost an impossible task. It is no good way to measure productivity, right? You can only judge by business value delivered. But if you want to say, what is your name?
Avinash.
What is Avinash's productivity? Is he as good as Rahul or in a particular team kind of productivity? It doesn't really, it's a tough thing to do. So that's why, the Agile metrics are, within Agile, as you all know, we say customer value is paramount, right? It's all about delivering customer value. But we still have this hangover. At the back of it, we have all our managers are engineers. And engineers like precision. Right. So somehow we want, as engineers, we want to slip in some goals and metrics, and we're not content with the business customer saying, you guys did a fantastic job. I'm so happy. You delivered your system. I'm going to recommend you to up the chain, and my product is happy. My users are happy, but I want metrics. Because your managers are engineers.
Obviously, I am
also engineer. There you go.
The problem is that the customer says, okay, you have done a wow job.
Yeah.
But then they will say, okay, how to measure?
So let me come back to the wow job, customer satisfaction.
Yes.
So absolutely, you can have a customer satisfaction survey, do just a simple point. Go read The Ultimate Question, right? It's a book by Fred Reichel, and it's about measuring customer satisfaction. And they say the best way to measure customer satisfaction is to whether if the person you deliver the service to is willing to refer you to a friend or colleague. So that one question, because when they refer you to somebody, they're going to put their own reputation on the line. So if you get Net Promoter Score, that's what it's called, right? You can do an NPS, Net Promoter Score, and that's a value and measure of customer satisfaction. It's already there. It's industry standard. This is the problem, right? The entire industry follows something like that. But we as software engineers, with the focus on the word engineer, we want to introduce our own metrics and try and sneak in some from CNN. So, okay. So and on the question of productivity, you can go to the Agile Project Management mm-hmm. discussion group, Yahoo group. Right now there's a discussion going on about productivity. Okay. And every now and then, few months, every years, you know, we've been trying. In the old days, they used to say, how do you measure productivity? Lines of code. Right?
Yeah, actually, that
yeah.
we know that okay, lines of code is no
matter. Yeah, now we're saying that, but insanely, 10 years ago, people would say, "Oh, I'm writing more lines of code than you." Then it was made easy by like copy and paste, you know? Control C, Control C.
Actually,